Just 2 days after the federal budget warned unemployment would rise, it has.
The labour market is easing, but it's not easing drastically.
The March rate already revised up to 3.9%, jumping to 4.1% in April, despite the emergence of 38,000 new jobs. The impact on interest rates...
We're still expecting that the Reserve Bank will be in a position to start cutting rates starting from about November of this year.
The government focusing on the increase in part-time employment...
820,000 jobs, and most of them full-time, have been created on this Prime Minister and this government's watch.
As Reserve Bank Chief Economist Sarah Hunter reveals, the RBA is yet to decide whether Tuesday's budget will deliver on its promise of forcing inflation below 3% by Christmas.
The guys back at headquarters, they're working through the numbers right now, and we're assessing what it means for inflation.
Tonight, opposition leader Peter Dutton delivers his budget reply. Seven News can reveal he'll promise to slash migration, free up housing supply, and introduce much tougher knife and domestic violence laws.
Mr Dutton will commit the coalition to slashing the permanent migration intake from about 190,000 a year to 140,000 and substantially reducing the number of international students, promising to free up 100,000 homes and recommit to the super for housing policy the government rejects.
We want to build more homes and they want to wreck super.
Mr Dutton will also outline uniform knife laws banning sales to teenagers, tougher bail laws for domestic violence, and recommit to nuclear energy without naming reactor sites. Mark Riley, 7 News.